Well, I'm joined here today with Shaggy Law, the biggest artist out on the music scene at the minute. I mean, this man's been tearing down the scene. Tell us how you've been getting all these tracks down and done.
You really are sad, you know that.
Shaggy, what's your problem? You gotta liven up and have a laugh sometimes.
I'm not a rapper.
No, you're a R&B singer. You're like Usher. But you look a bit like a fat Justin Timberlake.
I am not a fat Justin Timberlake.
No, we all know that. Yeah, you definitely are. But let's get back to a real interview. I'm joined with Simon Law, and he's going to tell us about the HND media. So tell us about why you want to do something in the media.
Because everybody knows media. It's getting better and better every single year. You'll probably be more famous as a director than an actor. Well, not all the time. You just take Brad Pitt, for example. He didn't star in the best movies, but everybody loves him.
Tell us about what role of work you'd like to go into and what most interests you.
Probably editing or directing, something like that.
Editing and directing.
So what sort of stuff do you want to edit? What line of like stuff do you want to get into? And is it for documentary or drama?
Films such as, like, well, my favourite genre of films is sci-fi. Yes, I pretty much guess that, yes. And comedies are always good. But now just probably documentaries, factual films, historic films, something like that, just starting off with and then getting, building up.
Hear a bit about the films that you've made and what stuff you've been incorporated and involved in within your media career so far.
All I've done so far in my media career is design a magazine and front contents page for manga anime magazine. It's sad, but it's the only thing I could think of, and I was the only one doing it. And the second thing was designing a 3-minute trailer for a movie I designed called Change, which is currently in my bag if anybody wants to see it.
Was this like for college or was this off your own back? And how did your publishing of the magazine go? And was it a real thing that you could go out and buy, or was it just a made up myth?
The movie was for coursework. And so, but I got to keep a copy, and the magazine, that was also for coursework, and it's only just the front cover and contents page. However, it is quite good and based on something very good.
What are you going to do for your factual production?
I'm doing the history of Truro Cathedral.
So run me a bit about the history and about the cathedral. Have you been doing your research?
We discovered that it took 30 years of people just debating where to go. He lost both his feet.
Boom, 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 busting. But have you been there filming yet and doing your field log sheets and your recces and stuff like that?
We've got some photos of what we might want to shoot in the film. We have been there, we have permission. Oh God, she's laughing. Katie, trusted cameraman, will be getting some night shots and getting seeing if Truro Cathedral lights up at night, which hopefully she's discovered yet. There's only, yes, it does. That's excellent. Antonio is also a cameraman, and he's done a great amount of research. And yes, stop laughing. You are that sad. And what's so funny?
But anyway, getting back to the interview, after you blew your grubby little nose full of bogeys. But so run us by a few of your favourite directors and why you like them and what sort of films are inspirational to you.
Probably one of my favourite directors. Hey, focus on the face if you're not anything else. One of my favourite directors at the moment is Tim Burton.
Tim Burton, what films is he associated with then?
Batman, Forever, not Batman Forever, that movie sucked. Batman, and all those old, like, when it was the huge gothic ones, like, kept the one with Catwoman and Penguin in, and all those dark tone ones that really changed the tone of the whole Batman genre forever. He's doing Sweeney Todd, and I just saw the trailer last week, and it is fantastic. Any Johnny Depp fans, you have to see this.
So you've heard it here from the horse's mouth. You've got to see this film, because it's going to be big, you know what I mean?
The film's called Sweeney Todd, and it's about a serial killer, anti-hero slash villain.
Getting back to Sweeney Todd, I know all about that, because I see him in the London dungeons.
Right, okay, apparently he may or may not have existed, and you know that he slit people's throats with a razor blade and then put them into pies.
Yeah, that's what he done. I seen him and he scared me when I was at the London dungeons.
Well, I can't remember I probably don't remember seeing him in London dungeons. I just thought it was a musical before, but it's supposedly based on true events, so.
Yeah, definitely, but that's what they do. They just got loads of sorts of myth and real at the London dungeons.
There's an old woman sat down in the London dungeon. My dad thought, okay, what's in the Madame Tussauds part horror section? And he said, what do you think this old woman did? And he said, I'm actually an old woman. I'm not actually an old woman, not a waxwing. And he said, oh, sorry.
Well, I think we'll round this interview up. Is there anything else you want to say to inspiring filmmakers like yourself?
Don't be this guy. Do not be this guy. He kind of sucks.
Well, thank you very much. It's back to you in the studio, Kate. Boom, 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 busty. Hear me fantastic. Touch me on my box, you call me Mr. Roe. Whoa, whoa, Monty. Hear me fantastic. She touch me on my box, she says Mr. Boom.